my name is Sachelle Coley. I'm a sophomore at Miramar High School, and I'm in the IB program, and I'm doing my personal project based on makeup. You know, it's kind of creative. It's something that I love to do. It's like my second passion, you know, after singing. So I hope you guys enjoy it and, you know, just sit back and take some tips. But now I'm going to show you what not to do when it comes to makeup. Okay, this is the way that makeup should not be done. First and foremost, as you can see on her eyes, the eyeshadows, they don't go together. You have orange, green, and red. First, they're not blended correctly. And as you can see, she attempted to do a wing, but it must have escalated and came down like a little roller coaster. It came all the way down to her eye. Secondly, you have her blush. When you're doing your blush, may you smile for me, please? You go on your cheekbones. You don't do it in a circular motion. And thirdly and lastly, her lipstick. It's only on one lip, as you can see, and that's not the right way to do it. Okay, here's another example of what not to do when it comes to makeup. As you can see, it looks like this person played in her mother's makeup kit, which is not acceptable. So first, we have the eyes. As you can see on her right eye, she left residue of eyeshadow under her eye, which is acceptable. You have to take something and wipe that off. Her eyeshadows, they don't go together. You have green on the side, what looks like a reddish pink right here, and blue. Secondly, her blush. She just went all over the place with it, which is not acceptable. Her foundation isn't really her skin color. And her lips, no, that's just a no. She used what looks like a red lipstick to line her lips and like a creamish to put on the inside. That's a no. Okay. As you previously saw, those were ways not to do makeup. So I'm here to show you the correct way to, you know, have a perfect face. Okay, first we'll start out with the foundation, and I'm using the CoverGirl Clean Normal Skin, and it's in shade 165 Tawny. Okay, so first we'll start off with that. Normally put it on your wrist, so to get a better access. I normally dab all across my face and try not to get it in your hair either. Okay, mix it all around. If you see areas that you think aren't fully covered, then you can dab again and go back to it. That'll be it for my foundation. Okay, now as you can see, I applied my foundation to my face, and you have to make sure that you apply it evenly. Don't just do it on one side and call it a day. Apply it evenly. I use the foundation that's closer to my skin tone. Unlike the others, one of them, they actually used a foundation that was a little bit brighter than their actual skin tone. But as you can see, I get mine that's closer to my skin tone. Okay, now we're gonna do the eyes. And before I put my eyeshadow on, I actually use the eyeshadow primer. Right now, I'll be using the eyeshadow primer by Milani. And this is just to make sure that your eyeshadow, it stays in place. And like it becomes brighter, it's more vibrant then. So you don't have to use too much. You can use this, just a little pinch. That was the left eye, and now the right. Now that that is done, you can just jump right into the eyeshadow because you have your primer on now. Okay, now I'll be applying my eyeshadow. And I'm using like a gold shimmery color, and it's by LA Colors. But I'm gonna put it in the top just to, you know, be safe. Gotta tap it to make sure most of it comes out. That should be enough. Okay. Okay. Okay, as you can see, this eyeshadow, it kind of likes to spread on your face. So just take your foundation brush and go over it one more time to get off the rest of the brush. Okay, now I'm using a bigger brush with bigger bristles to get more of an exaggeration look, and I'm using like a darkish brown. And you start in the crease and then you make your way up. Okay, as you can see, I use like a dark brown in my crease area on both eyes just to like give it like a smokyish eye kind of, and an exaggeration. And above that, I use like under my brow, I used from my e.l.f. I used like just like a lighter color to highlight the top area to give it more of an oomph. Okay, now I'm gonna apply my eyeliner because I already did my eyeshadow. And it's by Rimmel London, and it's called the Exaggerate Eyeliner. I'm gonna do the wing with my eyeliner to give it more of a cutesy look. And try to bring it all the way down, but be careful not to go on your eye. Okay, lastly regarding my eyes, I'm gonna use a dark, just straight black eyeliner for my waterline, and I'm gonna use Rimmel London Scandalous Flex mascara for my eyelashes. So here we go. Okay, regarding my eyes, I first started with the primer and then I added my gold eyeshadow. And then I used my brown and like a highlight on the top. After that, I used my liquid eyeliner to do the wing and just make it longer and go to the side. So that's the simple things that you can do for your eyes. Okay, at this moment, I'm gonna do my lips. And before anything, I'm gonna line my lips with the brown lip liner to like give it an outer layer, and then I'm gonna use like a simple lip gloss and my lipstick. Now my lipstick is kind of like a nudish color. The reason I chose this color is because I have a bright eye, and normally with a bright eye, you tend to go with colors that don't take away attention from your eyes. Now if you have a dark eye, you can, the brighter the better for the lip because it gives it that pop and that exaggeration. So here we go. Okay, as you can see, I applied my lip. It's not too bright or it's not too dark. It doesn't take away from the eyeshadow, which is a good thing, so. It's kind of like a nudish color, and just gave it some lip gloss to make it a little glossy. Okay, hey guys, it's Sachelle. This is the finished look. As you can see, first I applied my foundation. I used the foundation that was actually my skin tone color. I recommend that you guys do that, if not as close as possible. Secondly, I did my eyes. First I primed it, and then I put the eyeshadow. And I used a highlight for the top to give it like a better oomph. Yeah. So then after that, I did my wing eyeliner, and like the others, you saw that they did above and under. That's not the way you do it. And after that, I did my waterline and I did my eyelashes with my mascara. After that, I did my lips. It's not mandatory that you actually use lip liner, but it's best that you do to give it more of a pop. And after that, which was last, I put my setting powder on to give it more of an even foundation. So that's it. This is kind of like an everyday look. You can use it if you're going somewhere, going out, like to a party, if you're going to school, church, whichever. I mean, just have fun with it. Bye.